Advanced Photoshop users not welcome. This tutorial is strictly for beginners without any Photoshop experience. In this blur effects tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create a simple motion blur in Adobe Photoshop. The motion blur provides an impressive effect that can be used to enhance many different photos to give them the illusion of movement. This is a follow-up from the previous zoom effect tutorial. If you want to watch the previous tutorial on zoom blur effect, please press the above link. If you want to follow with the original image, the link is below. In order to successfully complete this tutorial and get immediate results, please ignore all other tools on Photoshop and only focus on the ones necessary for this task. Okay, we're going to be following up from the previous tutorial on zoom blur effects. This motion blur effect is slightly different in the way that we have to mask our subject before we can apply this effect. So you can say that it's a little bit more complex than our previous tutorial on zoom blur effects. As you can see, I have the same picture opened up again. And this time round, we're going to have to mask the subject in the front. Masking is going to be a little bit more involved than we would like because the background is so busy. But anyway, let's start by right-clicking on our background layer and duplicate layer. We're going to call this cut out. Cut out. Okay? Because this is the layer we're going to be using for masking, and then press OK. So we've got our cutouts layer, and I'm going to take my zoom tool, which is here. So let me zoom into the figure to see what we're doing. I'm going to left click on the top left hand corner and drag down to my right hand bottom corner and then release so that I can see the subjects more clearly. The next thing we have to do is select our quick selection tool here, okay? If the quick selection tool is not there by default and instead it's the magic wand tool, press down with your left button and select the quick selection tool. Now, we're going to adjust the brush so that it's large enough to fit into the parts where his body is, but small enough so that it doesn't overlap onto the background. So I would say a little bit smaller than the size of his ankle would be good enough. Something like that would be good. For the hardness, keep the brush soft. I've got it at 4%. I think I'm going to leave it at that. We're going to start by clicking our left button down and just dragging it over the subject, okay? And like I said before, it's a little bit more complex because can you see that it's also selected some of the background, but don't let that worry you. Okay, so we're going to continue selecting our subjects as much as we can, and later on we'll come and fix the mistakes made in the background with another tool. Right, so I've selected as much of the subject as possible with the quick selection tool, okay, but at the same time I've also selected some of the background, but like I said, don't let that worry you. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to use this other tool here, the polygon lasso tool. And with the lasso tool, we're going to be selecting this icon here, which is the subtraction tool. So we'll be using that to minus all the mistakes we made on the background. So what I'll do, I'll take my zoom tool first of all, okay, and I'm going to go much closer. Okay, I think that's probably good, okay? And if you want to scroll up and down, you can actually use the wheel on your mouse to scroll up and down. Otherwise, you can use the scroll bar to navigate up and down. At the moment, the feather is on 0 pixels. Okay, I think we're going to leave it like that for now because we can adjust that later on when we refine the edge a little bit. So what we do, once again, we're going to select our polygon lasso tool, okay, this one here, and we're going to start subtracting from the selection with this tool. As we go along our subject's profile, you have to left click on the mouse move the mouse to the next point, okay, and then click again. And this is how it works. So what I'm doing, I'm left clicking, moving on, left clicking again. What I'm going to do, I'm going to select this, and I'm going to go all the way around until I have the selection. And to close the selection, I just simply double click. Okay, and as you can see, it selected most of his face. Okay, I'm going to quickly try and do the rest so that we don't waste time. I might speed the video up at this point. So basically what I'm doing is using the polygon lasso tool to subtract the mistakes I made with the quick selection tool. We've also accidentally missed out from the selection part of our subject. Okay, for example, if I scroll up, you can see that here I've actually left out some of his shirts. The way to go around this is by using the add tool on the polygon lasso tool, which is this one here, to add the parts to the selection. Just like before, you have to left click on the mouse, move the mouse to the next point, and then click again, and then double click when you finish selecting your selection. Okay, I'm going to fit it on the screen now and see. Oh, we've forgotten the foot here. So let me just add his foot back in. Okay. Right. And I think that's about it. Okay. Apart from here, let me just finish this bit here like that. Okay. You can be more detailed if you like. But it's not really necessary, because we're going to see later on that we're going to be using a tool called the Refine Edge tool, which will be fixing any problems we have with the image. Okay? Anyway, so I think that's basically that's selected. Now that it's selected, okay, whilst we've got this selected, the Polygon Lasso tool selected, we can go up to the Refine Edge and press that button, okay? And it's going to select our image. And what we want to do is we want to give it a bit of a feather, okay? So that, and also shift the edge just slightly, okay? So that it's taken off from the subject. Okay, so it's that way around. If I push this lever all the way, you see that that would reduce our subject and cut off quite a lot of the image. Okay, but we're not going to leave it like that. We're just so that we're sure that it's not taking the background. That's why we want to shift the edge slightly inwards. And also give it a bit of a feather, which means that it's gonna be softer on the edge. Okay, and then once we've done that, we press OK. Right, we've done that. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna come down here to the layer mask, and we're gonna press this icon here to add a layer mask. So if I hide the bottom layer by pressing the eye icon, okay, you can see that, you know, we've just got the subject and that's it. Anyway, I'm going to go back and I'm going to go onto the background layer and enable this again by pressing the eye icon. First, I'll select the background layer. Once that's selected, then, you know, we're ready to make our blur effect. Okay, so I'm going to come up here to the filter, press filter, blur, and we're going to go to motion blur and press motion blur. And straight away, you'll see there's an effect there. Okay, the distance is 123 on this one, but you can have your own preference on this setting, and you can have it higher or lower. I think about 85, I think this is good. 85 is good enough for this effect. So I'm going to leave it at 85. And basically, that's it. Then I can save the document. And there you have it, the motion blur effect. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I look forward to seeing you in my next tutorial. Thanks for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, please leave your comments below and subscribe to my channel.